Well, good afternoon on this Friday. It's been a soggy start to our day with all of that heavy rain that came through overnight into this morning. But as we head through the rest of our day and through the afternoon, the rain will continue to taper off from southwest to northeast, and that's going to leave us with some drier conditions and pleasant conditions as we head into the weekend ahead of next week when we turn cooler and see that next round of showers. You'll notice some of the wind gusts that we've seen generally in the 20s, gusts 20 to 25 miles per hour, a few isolated gusts up near 30, and then Rochester gusting to 37 today, Portsmouth gusting to 48. There's been some really impressive winds right near the coast as we've ended the morning and headed into the early part of the afternoon. And as far as rainfall totals go, we've seen some significant rainfall being reported across the state, many areas picking up over an inch, over 2 inches of rain, isolated amounts over 3 inches, especially up north of the Conway area, and even more than that, some reports over 4 inches, several inches reported as you head towards some of those mountain areas and some of those southeast facing slopes. So yeah, really impressive rainfall with this system that we've seen across the area. You'll notice on the satellite and radar loop, this is the past 12 hours, and you can see how some of that heavy rain really came through during the overnight into the morning, those yellows and oranges indicating the downpours. And then as we've headed into the early part of the afternoon, it's starting to taper off, and we're going to continue to see that rain taper off through the day. So these next couple of hours will feature the showers gradually moving back to the north and east, and we'll get into a little bit of clearing southwest towards Keene and across Cheshire and Sullivan counties as the day goes on. And by this evening, I expect some dry conditions across the state. There may be some lingering clouds up north with a little moisture across some of the high terrain, but otherwise the evening commute should be much better than what we had out there this morning. We'll see drier conditions this evening, and as we head overnight into the weekend, we'll actually stay on the quiet side, so the winds die down and we'll get back into a good deal of sun to start the weekend on Saturday. So as we head through the rest of the day, there's a couple of lingering showers up north as this pulls away, but generally back into some clearing and drying conditions. Temperatures still hanging on to those mild highs in the 60s. And then tonight, lows fall back into the 40s. We'll get into some clearing, and there likely will be areas of fog overnight into tomorrow morning too, with a lot of that moisture that we have at the surface. So just keep that in mind as well. Otherwise, the 7-day forecast keeps things pretty nice through the weekend. Sunday also in the 60s with some sun, but we see a chance for showers early next week, and cooler temperatures return by Tuesday, highs down in the 50s.